700 police. Let's talk about it. If the Coronapocalypse and all the social distancing and all the depressing news that we're hearing on social media and everywhere has got you down with the sickness, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button. Hey guys, so welcome to Phoenix Arms and Defense. I'm Chris Smith, and today's episode is a tabletop review. In fact, it's a tabletop review on an item that is really good at social distancing or creating social distance. Just kidding. I got a demented sense of humor. So if you don't like it, tell us how bad your butt hurts in the comments below. So you just add publicity for me and it makes things very fun. So anyways, without further ado, let's talk about this rifle. I don't really have much to say on it other than going over the specs, because the accuracy of this thing, you'll see for yourself in the next video that I'm going to have up this afternoon. So we're going to kind of go in over the specs here, and we're just going to go ahead and get down and dirty with it. So what we have here is a Remington 700 Police. Now, this is not your typical Remington 700 hunting rifle. This is a rifle that is designed for law enforcement and military uses. It is a precision rifle. So this one here is, like we said, it's a 700 platform. It is a short action. That is also a bolt gun, bolt action. So you gotta use a bolt, manually enter the cartridges in. Short action means it's using a shorter action compared to a 300 Win Mag or 30-06 or anything. 308 can be used on a short action. Same thing with 6.5 Creedmoor. This one is in 308 Winchester. The trigger on this thing is absolutely amazing. It's a 40 XP adjustable trigger, and we'll play with that here in just a minute. The barrel is going to be a 24-inch hammer-forged carbon steel with a 1-in-10 twist rate and 5R rifling. That gives you a lot of really good stuff in your favor when it comes to slinging lead out at extreme distances. So we'll more on that in a moment. The stock's made by HS Precision. They make really good stocks. Of course, it's a free-floated barrel and all that nice stuff, so your barrel harmonics are right. Again, more things that help you and give you all the advantages for the accuracy aspect. The magazine is a 4-round internal, but you can squeeze a fifth one in the chamber if you depress the follower. We'll talk about that in a second. And our overall length is 4.7 inches, and without the scope and all the doodads on here, she weighs about 9 pounds. Of course, with all the doodads on here, you were probably looking at about 11 and a half pounds, somewhere in that range. Now, as far as the accessories that I got on here, we're going to go from the back end all the way to the front like we normally do. Back here in the back, I do have a slip-on recoil pad back here. So, you know, helps tame the recoil a little bit, gives you all that advantages, makes it easier for you, you know, not anticipate recoil and everything, because everything matters at long distance. We got a Black Hawk cheek rest here, and I made a little bit of a modified styrofoam riser under here that I use electrical tape on, covered up. It's crude, but it works. It gets the job done. Cheek rest has got leather up here on top, which is really nice. It's also got a 5-shell holder here and a pocket for your data book, which is pretty cool. Moving forward here, we have got the base is going to be a Weaver 20 MOA base. The rings are going to be Vortex, and the scope itself is Vortex, the 6.5 to 20 by 50 Vortex Viper. The first gen, so really good scope. We'll get onto that in a second. And then the last thing that I added here is we've got a Harris 6-9 bipod, so pretty cool. So let's go ahead and pick this little girl up. Man, whew. So the bipod just folds under like so. We'll move our way back, talking about everything. So she does extend out. You got 6 inches or 9 inches. That's what you get. You push the button, and it automatically retracts. It's got spring tension, so it doesn't go nowhere. And then when you have it folded, she don't go nowhere, and you can pew-pew at long ranges, and it gives you a stable platform, so that's a big one. Taking this thing apart, you move them down here, you have the magazine floor plate, got a jam or anything, you just push that little button right there at the front trigger guard, And boom, she pops right out, squeeze her back in, and boom, done. Bolt, right there, obviously. Bolt release is underneath the trigger. That just wiggles out, like so. And bada bing, bada boom. Easy disassembly, easy cleaning. Very easy maintenance. It's one of the things I love about this gun. Safety is straightforward. It's not complicated, no BS. I like that. It is on safe, which is all the way back, on fire all the way forward. And speaking of fire, let's talk about this awesome trigger. So here, this trigger is literally not a two-stage, it's a single stage. Once that safety's off, if you've got this puppy tuned down, because I've got it tuned down to probably about 3 pounds, give or take. I don't really know. I need to seriously get a scale or a trigger puller or trigger scale, whatever the hell it's called. And we need to think about investing in one of those so we can talk about this. But anyways, about 3 pounds. Once your finger's on the trigger, that's it. There's just a teeny bit of take up, actually barely any. It's negligible at best. And then gun breaks. I mean, it is just stupid smooth, so you can get the best possible groupings. I mean, it's just, we're just gonna do that again because the trigger's just that freaking awesome. But here we go again. Tiny bit of take up, boom, she goes off. You almost don't even notice the take up. Which is awesome. I like that. Gives you consistency. And then moving down. We'll talk about the scope a little bit. Get her up here. We got the Butler Creek. I didn't mention that before. We got the Butler Creek lens protectors up here. This one, just push the red button, flips up. Pretty cool. Your magnification here is going to be right here. It's got a, like I said, 6.5 to 20 power. It does have a little line at the 14 power dot, and that is to tell you that's where your mil dot is set. This is a second focal plane scope, it's not a first focal plane. So reticle doesn't get bigger. It stays the same no matter what. So 14 power, if you got to use your mil dots, that's where you're at. Moving on, you got your windage adjustments here. They're just protected by a cap. That's probably one of my only complaints about the scope. They're set. You can set them for whatever your zero is, etc. And then you got elevation up here as well. And then, get back on there, you bug. And then over here on the other side, you got your focus for distances. It goes from, you know, 50, 60, 70, 100. 150, 2, 3, 4, 5, and all the way over to infinite. So pretty cool. And then the scope is a mil dot reticle like we just talked about. All right, now pros and cons, and then we'll cover cost. Pros and cons. Pros, this gun will shoot better and I'm fully capable. I do not in any way, shape, or form claim to be a top-notch precision shooter. I like to dabble with it because it's just absolutely downright fun and it tests the fundamentals, and that's one of the things I absolutely love about it. Besides shooting fully automatics, shooting at extreme distances is one of the other ways I love to get my rocks off. I love shooting these guns at far distances. And the 308, why I picked it as a beginner was because it's a good round to teach you what you need to know. It's been around for a long time. There's lots of low data on it. I mean, it's a good platform to learn on. Next time eyeing a 6.5 Creedmoor because those things are just freaking laser beams. I mean, they're ungodly accurate. So that's pretty cool. Moving on, so pros and cons. So like I said, the pros, this gun can shoot extremely accurately. Half-inch groups, I've had no problem squeezing out of at 100 yards. No issues, none. It's pretty sweet. Long distances, you're going to see that in the next video, which the link will be in the description. It will be released as soon as this one is uploaded, so you will be able to see that back-to-back. Because we immediately took this thing out to a range review and shot it. In fact, I'm doing the tabletop post-range review. It's impressive. So the accuracy is there. No questions about it. As long as you're using good bullets, which we will briefly hit on in the next video. Far as the cons go, I mean, like I said, pros, everything. This thing is set up. This platform is set up to maximize your success at those distances. It is made for precision shooting. Moving on to the cons. I'm gonna start with the scope. I love Vortex. Warranty's great, fantastic scope. I got no complaints about the company. However, this is a MOA adjusted turrets with a mil dot reticle. So when you bottom the scope out, which is very easy to do with a 308, you have to do a rough conversion from MOA to mils in order to use your dots and your reticles. So that's kind of a pain in the ass, just a little bit. But it can be done, it's just a quick conversion. If you're not under any stress or you haven't memorized, it's doable, it's very doable. The only other con I can really say on this gun, it's really not a con, but it's just a heavy bastard. I mean, it's a heavy girl. It's a big girl. It's got a lot of stuff on her. This is not going to be something you're going to be wanting to take out elk hunting out in the middle of nowhere when you have to hike, you know, miles to get to a stand or whatever to get that perfect shot. You're going to have some serious endurance with the thing or carry a lighter rifle. So she is a heavy gun. But in the role that I'm using it in, doesn't really matter because I'm using it literally to test myself and push myself and see what kind of shooting I can do at extreme distances. So that is pretty much everything I've got. So with that, we'll go ahead and wrap this up. Like always, I am not sponsored. I forgot to mention this at the beginning. Not sponsored by Remington or Vortex. I bought all this stuff with my own money. Speaking of that, cost on this whole setup, I have about $1,700 with everything you see here, give or take, which is actually pretty good for a precision rifle under $2,000. I would definitely recommend this as a good starter rifle, an intermediate rifle even, because there's nothing starter about this thing. This thing literally, I know I've said this, and I'm going to say it one more time, it sets you up for success for long-range shooting. I am very pleased with this rifle. We went over costs, specs. I think that's it. Okay. All right, guys. So without further ado, like I said, I know I didn't harp on the accuracy too much. You're going to see that in the next video, so check that out. With that, hope you guys are staying safe out there. Hope you guys are having a fantastic Easter weekend. And I will see you guys on the next episode next time. And remember, guys, your right to self-defense is self-maintained. I'm Chris Smith with Phoenix Arms and Defense. Thank you guys for watching.